Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are still here after my very long absence, then I really want to thank you for that. And I'm on here to give you a little bit of a life update, to tell you where I have been, what I have been doing, why I haven't been filming on this channel. Mainly because I was filming in another channel called myprelovedaffair, which I will link in the description box down below just in case you wanted to go there. But really the main reason why I haven't been filming on this channel is because I was ashamed. I am still ashamed, actually, and it's taking a lot of determination for me to come in front of the camera and film once again on this channel, because I've talked big about doing a low buy year, going on no buy challenge and all that stuff in the last videos that you would have seen on this channel. I've talked about how I am trying to curb my shopping addiction and what I am doing to do that, to accomplish that. I've said so many things and done zero about it. So that's why I haven't been filming. In fact, I've created an entire channel, that one called My Preloved Affair, because I kept shopping. I kept buying preloved. Okay, that's my excuse. It's preloved, so it's okay. I'm saving the planet by taking stuff that would have ended up in landfill and putting it in my closet so that it could be stored there for all eternity, never to be used. So yeah, that's one of the reasons why, well, that's the main reason why I haven't been filming. On that other channel, I've got probably a few more scheduled videos and a few past, probably under 20 videos, because I do like a weekly, like a Saturday upload, and it's all about me going thrifting, buying secondhand items online, and really indulging myself, to be perfectly honest, which was not what I said that I was going to do the last time I spoke to you guys. So I have been hiding in shame all this time. And in case you haven't also noticed or been updated, if you were following me on Instagram, my initial Instagram account, originally My Preloved Affair, the one that I have had since 2013, has been deleted by Instagram for apparently violating some terms and conditions, which they never told me what it was about. There was no way I could redeem that account, so I had to create another one, which I'm also linking in the description bar down below. That is obviously My Preloved Affair version 2.0. And yeah, so that's what's been happening. I've been trying to rebuild that Instagram account. I've been hiding in shame from this account and posting in another YouTube channel, hoping that the internet people will not see that I have eaten all of my words and choked on it. Nonetheless, I'm coming here in front of you guys to admit that, to sort of like take accountability for my shame and my irresponsible behavior, and restarting. So in fact, I had created a new blog, which I always do but never seem to keep updated, but I created a new blog called 40 and 5-4, because I still intend to keep it as a pre-loved fashion lifestyle kind of blog. But in the last, I don't know what sparked it, why I all of a sudden felt like I'm almost 40. In less than 6 months, I will be 40. And I look at my bank account and I thought to myself, this is not gonna be enough for retirement. And given this unprecedented time of pandemic, I haven't been, you know, you'd think that because I can't shop in stores, it would be okay. But because I do a lot of my shopping online even before the pandemic, and then having to work from home again after I've left my previous job because I didn't really like working from home, given me a lot of time in my hands to keep shopping. So it's not about the pandemic, it's just sort of like given me more resources to keep shopping. And the other thing is, I looked at my closet and it was brimming with clothes, about half of it I haven't worn after I bought it. So, as you would have probably seen on my on the title of this video, this is going to be a restart. So, like that blog that I created, 40 and 54, is going to be a restart. Actually, the first post there is press restart. Again, linking in the description bar down below. And I have been spending some time thinking about my finances. I'm debt-free. I don't have anything on my credit card. I have been able to put away some savings. However, it's not as much as I thought that I would, because like I said, I kept shopping despite having said that I wouldn't do that. Oh, and also, addressing the elephant in the room, I did cut my own bangs. Okay, if you want to follow the tutorial that I followed to get these bangs, I'm going to link him down below. His name is Brad Mondo. So, yeah. Just, okay, going back to my initial point. So, yeah, this is a restart. If you have been with me here on this channel for a while, you know that I love to shop, I love to haul. At first, it was brand new items. I was addicted to makeup for a long period of time. And then it became clothes, and then I discovered buying secondhand and justifying that with how my carbon footprint is so much less now that I'm not buying new. I am helping charities because I buy from Vinnie's and Salvo's and op shops and all that. And that I am, it's not breaking the bank because it's a fraction of the cost of buying brand new. Hold that thought. That's what happens when I talk too much. That's a smoothie, a strawberry banana smoothie with almond milk. Yeah. So anyway, I've had a lot of excuses as to why it's okay for me to keep buying and purchasing things that I often end up not actually using. In fact, I've actually started journaling again. Well, not really journaling, but using this blank notebook and finally getting some use of my washi tapes. I got this from Muji. Yeah, got from Muji. It's a plain, unlined notebook. On my first, on the first page there, use some washi tape, is my wish list for 2020. The things that I still want to buy or feel the urge to buy. And I feel like writing it down has helped me to actually control it, because then I look at it and I think to myself, do I really need it? Like, the first thing on my wish list is a white eyelet dress or a white floral dress, maxi or midi. And now that I look at it, I'm thinking, wait a minute, I thrifted a Ted Baker white shirt dress that has got some vertical stripes. Maybe I don't actually need this. Actually, I don't need it. And it's winter. So this is something like in preparation for summer, which is like, we can't even go out. Where am I going to wear this shit? Okay. And then the second item on my wish list is a white or ecru leather bag. And then I think to myself, wait, I have that YSL sort of clutch bag. And a Gucci hobo bag that is, it's a very light gray that it is sort of off-white. And the YSL Angie bag is like really white with gold hardware. So why am I even putting this on my wish list? And I think writing it down and seeing it visually instead of just imagining it in my head is helping me sort of like curb that addiction. And then, the second page is my declutter list. Yes, I currently have 35 items on my declutter list, and you don't see it, but on my side here is the big IKEA boom bag that has 17 items in it. Well, plus, how many accessories did I just put in there? Probably 6. So 23 items in there. 27 items in there. I can barely lift the bag. And that's not even all of the things on my list that I will be decluttering. Why am I decluttering them? Because I have too many of the same things. One of my problems, especially when I was still buying brand new items, was that if I liked one thing, I would buy them in multiple colors. Good example for that. This Uniqlo tartan skirt, green and navy, with pockets, midi length. I have this in red and in a neutral color, sort of like cream and black. Why do I need 3 of them? I don't know. I just like them. I liked how it flowed. I liked how it looked on me. So I bought 3. I've got another Uniqlo skirt in a very bright blue. I liked how it was a circular skirt that sort of like gave me some shape and some definition. So I also bought it in a bright red. Do I wear the bright red? No, I don't wear the bright red. Why? Because I have the red version of this skirt. Case in point. I've been a Uniqlo addict for a while. Ribbed mock neck Uniqlo shirt. Guess what? Got it in tan. I've got it in forest green. And I have it in purple. Do I wear it? No. Why not? Because ribbed clothing doesn't look good on me. It emphasizes bulges that I don't want emphasized. So, what's going to happen to these things? They're going to be given away. If I total all of the things that I'm going to be giving away just in that pile, I probably could have saved $1,000. Like, this is like $50 each. I think this one was $60. So right here is $210 of barely worn, still brand new condition clothing. I have no words for myself. And seeing this, actually being able to touch and feel and sort of like put a number and even a price tag on the things that I'm wasting right now is really, really making me so ashamed of myself, and also so regretful and remorseful for having wasted all of that. So that's why we're restarting, because I feel the need to do this. I've also been, I've once again unsubscribed to YouTubers that sort of like trigger me to shop. People who always do hauls, especially the luxury community, because even if they're doing only one item haul, it's like thousands of dollars worth. And they make me drool, and they make me want to buy, and I shouldn't buy. I have also unfollowed those same people on Instagram, and I have also muted, I didn't unfollow, okay? I've also muted a lot of the secondhand resellers on Instagram that I follow. I didn't want to unfollow them because I still wanted to support that sort of like community, but also I think for at least for the month of August, where I am doing a no spend August, I'm only allowing myself to pay bills, to pay for transport, and to buy groceries. Okay, at least for the month of August, I don't want to see anything being sold to me. And it may be a little bit of a drastic measure, but I think I need it. And also, I'm not gonna be carrying, well, I should be carrying my debit card because of the pandemic, so you don't really wanna exchange cash. Yes, okay. However, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be transferring most of the money in that debit card into a separate account that I don't actually have a debit card for, and only leaving a certain amount of money every month in that card so that that's the only thing that I spend. I don't overspend. I don't bring my credit card with me because that's really only used for purchasing flights. Yeah, so that's the plan. That's what I want to do. I've also, the third page on here is also a list of YouTube videos that I plan to do in the next couple of weeks, which you will be seeing here. I actually wanted to ask you guys, since I do have those videos in my separate channel, My Preloved Affair, do you want me to upload that here? Or do I just leave it there? What are your thoughts? I don't really know what to do. And I feel really awkward because it's the first time I've put on a full face of makeup in a long time and put on accessories and did my nails. Ah, it's another thing. I won't be going to the nail salon anymore and pay $60 to get my SNS on. I actually purchased the SNS set for $40. And I plan on just doing it myself. I cut my own bangs because going to the hairdresser is going to cost me at least $40 just to get like a short trim and fringe. This is actually probably going to cost me $60, so I did myself. I've also deleted some apps. I'm going to actually insert a video screen recording of my phone where I deleted shopping apps. I did have to reinstall eBay and Amazon, and what was the other one that I reinstalled? That's it, eBay and Amazon. eBay because I sell my pre-loved bags there, and I have sold 5 so far. Yes, that was one of like probably the biggest struggles because I paid so much for those bags, so I didn't want to just give them away. And Amazon because we have Amazon Prime because my husband watches Prime videos, so I had to reinstall those. But I don't really use Amazon to buy anything, to be honest. Yeah, so it's been a rambly long video, but that's the update that I have for you guys today. I will be sharing with you my journey for the whole month of August. This is the first video that you're seeing of me talking about the no spend challenge and what are the parameters around it. As I'm filming this, it is the 28th of July, but I had actually started my no spend already yesterday, the 27th of July, Monday. I'm trying to see how well I can do this no spend for at least the week before my actual August whole month of no spending. So, I plan on showing you on a weekly basis, because what I'm also doing, apart from a no spend, is culling my wardrobe and taking one item out every day. So by the end of the month, I should be able to declutter 31 items. I'm already on 27 in that pile. But do you want me to show you what's being decluttered? I'm also going to talk about what I've sold. I'm planning on doing my first capsule wardrobe because we're going into spring come September. And what bags I'm still thinking of letting go from my collection. So I should probably do an updated collection video, right? And then tell you what I'm thinking of decluttering. All right, we're 20 minutes into this video. I hope I've updated you enough. Let me know in the comment section down below what else you want to hear from me. If you want me to share some of the YouTubers that I am currently following to help me be successful in this journey of no spending and curbing my shopping habit, and also what my future plans are. I've set up some goals on my new Instagram, and you probably will see less. Well, no, you'll still see fashion posts on there because I'm going to be using what I have in my closet to create outfits. And but you'll also see trickling of finance, no spend challenge, and things like that on my Instagram. So that's it. Thank you very much for watching. I'm sorry for being away so long. I hope I didn't waste 22 minutes of your time. And I'll see you all again in the next video. Probably still looking like this.